Good evening, everyone. I hope you all are doing good, especially during these hard times. I hope you all are following the safety protocols as well. I'm your maths tutor, Priyaskani, and we'll be starting with the very interesting chapter, that is Vietnam. So let's start, right? Let us discuss two important properties of positive integers, namely the Euclid's division algorithm and the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So in this chapter, we'll be discussing about two very important properties of positive integer. The first property is Euclid's division algorithm, and the second property is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So let's start with it. Euclid's division algorithm has to do with the divisibility of integers, right? So we have integers. What are integers? On a number line, if you actually plot the numbers from zero, if you move rightwards, you get the positive numbers. And if you move leftwards, you get the negative numbers. So this set of positive numbers, negative number and zero, they are known as integers. So this Euclid's division theorem that we'll be studying will be based on the divisibility of integers, right? Okay. It says any positive number A can be divided by another positive integer B in such a way that it leaves a remainder which is smaller than B. So we'll be seeing how this works, right? Okay. The fundamental theorem of arithmetic has to do with the multiplication of positive integers. That is the next part of the chapter that we'll be focusing on a bit later half of the chapter. Okay, so let's start with the Euclid's theorem first, right? We use it to prove the irrationality of many numbers such as root 2, root 3 and root 5. So what are irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0, right? So those are your irrational numbers. And we can use this theorem to prove the irrationality of numbers, right? Okay. We apply this theorem to explore when exactly the decimal expansion of a rational number, say P by Q, where Q is not equal to zero, is terminating, and when it is not non-terminating repeating. We can apply this theorem to explore not only about the irrational numbers, but also about the rational numbers and when they are terminating and when they are not terminating. Okay. Given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers Q and R satisfying E equals to BQ plus R, right? Okay. Where R is nothing but the remainder, Q is the quotient, P is the divisor and A is the dividend. So with examples, you will be clear about this concept. Euclid's divisional theorem is a technique to compute the highest common factor of two given positive integers. And how we'll actually find it, that we'll be seeing in the later half of the chapter. Just we'll be starting with that, and through the examples, we'll be very, very clear about the Euclid's divisional algorithm, right? Suppose we need to find the HCF, that is the highest common factor between the number 455 and 42. So here we'll be using Euclid's theorem, right? So according to Euclid's theorem, we have a dividend over here, that is 455. We have a divisor, which is 42. So if we divide 455 and 42, what will we get? Basically, we start with the larger integer, that is 455. So 455 is nothing but 42 into 10 plus 35. So here 455 is the dividend, 42 is the divisor, 10 is the quotient and 35 is the remainder, right? And according to Euclid's theorem, the divisor in this case becomes the dividend in the next case and the remainder becomes the divisor. That is, in the next portion, here we have 42, which is the divisor, and 35, which is the remainder. Now, next we'll be seeing that we'll be taking 42 as the dividend and 35 as the divisor. See? So now consider the divisor 42 and the remainder 35 and apply the division. So now the divisor 42 becomes the dividend over here and the remainder 35 becomes the divisor over here. And 7 is the remainder. And this will continue. This theorem, this concept will continue until and unless we get 0 as the remainder. Okay. So we are basically taking 42, which was the divisor earlier, becomes the dividend. 32, which was the remainder earlier, becomes the divisor. And 7 is the remainder, right? So now 35, which is a divisor over here, will become dividend in the next case, right? And the remainder over here, that is 7, will become the divisor in the next case. So it is now considered a divisor 35 and the remainder 7, and apply the division. So now the divisor 35 becomes the dividend over here, and the remainder 7 becomes the divisor over here. And now finally we get the remainder 0. So until and unless we get the remainder 0, we keep on applying this theorem. And this theorem is known as Euclid's theorem, right? Okay. Notice that the remainder has become 0 and we cannot proceed, right? Okay. Example 1, use Euclid's theorem to find the HCF of 4052 and 12576, right? Okay. Since 12, so we have to find out which is the larger number over here. So 12756 is larger, it is greater than 4052. So here we are using 12576 as the dividend, 4052 as a divisor, right? So it is basically 12576, since it is a larger number, it is the dividend over here. 4052 is the divisor over here, and we are getting 420 as the remainder. Now, according to Euclid's theorem, the divisor will become the dividend in next case, and the remainder will become the divisor. So 4052 will become the dividend and 420 will become the divisor, right? So 4052 is basically 420 into 9 plus 272, right? So 4052, that was earlier the divisor, now becomes the dividend. 420, which was earlier the remainder, becomes the divisor. And 272, we have the remainder. So now in the next case, what will happen? Next case, this 420, which is the divisor, will become dividend, and 272 will become the divisor, right? So next case, 420, which was the divisor earlier, becomes the dividend, and the remainder earlier, 272, becomes the divisor, right? So 420 will be 272 into 1 plus 148. So here 148 is the remainder, 272 is the divisor. So now again, 272 is the divisor. It will become what? Dividend in the next case. And the remainder 148 will become the divisor in the next case. And this will continue on and on until when? Until the time we get remainder to be 0, right? Okay. Now the divisor 272 becomes the dividend over here. And the remainder 148 becomes the divisor, right? And we get 124 to be remainder. Now, 148, which was the divisor earlier, becomes dividend, and the remainder 124 becomes the divisor, right? So 148 is equal to 124 into 1 plus 24. Now 124, which was the divisor earlier, becomes the dividend, and 24, which was the remainder earlier, becomes the divisor, and we are left with only 4 as the remainder, because 124 is 24 into 5 plus 4, right? Now, 24, which was the divisor earlier, becomes the dividend, and the remainder, which was 4 earlier, becomes the divisor. So 24 is equal to 4 into 6 plus 0. So now we will stop, because we are getting remainder to be 0. So this is how we go about it, right? I hope I had been as clear as possible, right? So basically, what are we trying to do in Euclid's theorem? We are having a dividend, we are having a divisor, and we are having a remainder. And how are we deciding upon, like, if we have two numbers A and B, which number will become the dividend and which number will become the divisor? The number that is greater will become the dividend. The number which is smaller becomes the divisor, right? And in the next step, the divisor becomes the dividend and the remainder becomes the divisor. And this will keep on and on and on until we get the remainder to be 0. I hope I have been as clear as possible with this theorem. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.